Good morning. So I am finally able to take a little nap. A little nap because I waited till the last minute to procrastinate to pack all my things, and I had to switch suitcases because that's a whole nother story. But I finally had finished packing like around, I don't know, like 6 or 7. Took a little nap. My flight isn't until 4, but I live roughly about 2 hours away from the airport. So I'm going to leave maybe in the next, I would say maybe the next hour I'll leave. That just gives me enough time to go just in case traffic, because it's normally real bad traffic where this airport is. And so, yeah. So we are on our way to Toronto. All right, so I wasn't able to like get me coming out of my place and all that because, so there was this dog that got off the leash running. I had never seen a dog before. And so I got bags in my hand, and I'm like, this dog is running, and I've never seen a dog, so I'm like, please don't bite me. I'm thinking it's going to bite me, so I just kind of stood there, and I had a definitive time when I'm like, okay, let me leave. So I noticed the dog was on the other side of a car that's next to mine. So I pretty much, like, had my door open because I still had to get my luggage in my trunk. So I said, let me wait a bit and just verify that this dog is not like gonna come up to my car or come up to me again. As soon as I put my luggage in the trunk, now I'm already irritated and frazzled because I don't know who this dog belongs to. Normally I like dogs, but I'm just like, I need to go. And so the dog jumps into my driver's seat and sits in my driver's seat. Now this dog paws are dirty as hell. And so I found the lady lives in my building. So the lady, I didn't know it was her dog at first, or I don't even know if it's her dog. It might not actually be her dog. So I'm screaming like he's in my car, and I'm screaming at the dog, get out. And he finally got out and got down, and I'm on my way. So I'm just a little like, I'm a tad irritated because the dog was dirty. So I'm just gonna, you know, I'm just gonna talk to y'all when I get like near the airport. So I finally made it through the airport, through customs. That took like an hour and a half to almost 2 hours. So I'm right here actually sitting waiting for my flight. I got there a little bit early, which was great. So it worked out.
Good evening, folks. Once again, flight time is the first open to be capable. You're currently approximately 20 minutes out from Toronto. We will be arriving on time into Toronto. Current weather at the airport is light winds. Warm 21 degrees Celsius. I'd like to thank you for flying with Air Canada Express today. Hope you've enjoyed your onboard service. Look forward to seeing you again soon.
Made it to Toronto.
I don't think y'all need to see the whole airport thing, so when I get like to my destination, I'll come back.
So the airports are like extremely hot. So I don't know if it's gonna be hot in Toronto. It said it's not, so I'm kind of
be quiet so people don't think I'm crazy. And I'm gonna be like sweating. I'm sweating so bad. I have a long sleep every day, but I'm like sweating, so. Yeah, I'll see you in the city.
So I finally got off the train to the city. So there's an actual train that goes from the airport to the actual city, downtown Toronto. So I took that. That was like $12.35. And now I am at the hotel.
Sorry, y'all. I didn't get the me actually checking in because she had said a lot of a mouthful, and I was trying to listen to her. So, yeah, this is the airport fit, and this is so nice. Oh, I'm not gonna show y'all my name. They actually have my name on that envelope. This is nice. Let me try to figure out where the light is. Oh, it's on the outside. That's where the light is. Yay, it's nice. This is the bathroom. I'm at the St. Regis Hotel in Toronto, by the way. If you wanted to know, this is the shower. I'll check that later because I'm very tedious about showers. And it's nice and cool. Oh, thank God I got slippers because I forgot to get slippers. And I really don't like my feet touching carpet. That I don't know where it's been or who's been on it. So yeah, this is a really nice room. I'm gonna set my bag up here. All right, so here it is with the lights on, y'all. It's really nice. It's really nice in here. Yeah. I really wanna just like chill out, but I need to not do that. So I need to actually go out. So I'm gonna pick a restaurant from the list of restaurants that I looked at like on TikTok, and I'm gonna actually go out. It's like 8 o'clock-ish, but the only thing about that is, stuff is gonna get ready to close. So I do need to get me something to eat. That's definitely, I need to do that. So I'm gonna go ahead and get myself ready, hop in a shower, all that jazz, and yeah. And I'm thinking, should I do my makeup? Huh. Or do I have time for that? Because that's an hour process. I feel like if I do that, by time I do all of that, it'll literally be like maybe 10:30. We not, you know what? It is what it is. I have to go out. I have to, yeah. Okay, so this is the fit. It's like now 10 p.m. So I gotta try to find somewhere that I can go. That's going to at least serve some type of food. Because I don't want this to go to waste. And it was gonna take me a little bit of time anyway to get somewhat together, but yeah, this is the fit. I'm just gonna wear some clear heels, and yeah, I'll let you know how it works out. Beep.
All right, so I'm back. That lounge slash club wasn't really my stilo. It was called Lobby. I don't really know how they did like a whole restaurant type thing, but it's, to me, I feel like in the States, we kind of call that like a club, not really a lounge, but I can see why, because it's really small. But yeah, that just wasn't me. I think I just have gone past the point of like clubbing. It's just not for me anymore. Yeah, it's just not for me. So, but I end up having a drink and it got me feeling like really nice, because I don't really drink that much. So, you know, and then I got some jollof rice. They gave me big portions too. This was like $20. I didn't think they was going to give me a big portion. And I got these suya wings. He said they're really spicy. I've never had suya wings before, so. I came to do what I needed to do, and that was get something to eat. So I did make it. It was a cover charge, but I mean, at the end of the day, I'm like, I'm hungry. And I had to catch an Uber, so. It would have been me trying to catch another Uber. But they were really nice in there. The bartender was really, really nice. She was kind of telling me how things worked. And the guy that I got the food from, it was like a catering type thing. So they catered food. I just was like, look, if I pay this cover charge, I need to make sure I can get food. And they was like, yeah, it's food there. So I thought it was like a restaurant. Maybe it's a restaurant during the day. I don't know. But it's pretty small. And clearly, I stick out like a sore thumb, because they knew I was American. And I'm just like, how can you tell? How can you tell I'm American? And it's like, oh, you know, are you by yourself? Because it's other Americans in there. And I'm like, I don't know. I just feel like Toronto in America is just kind of the U.S. Toronto in the U.S. is kind of like... It's really nothing. I feel like it's nothing different. They drive crazy out here. I'm going to keep it a bean. They drive crazy. Like, they drive on the lines and everything. I felt like my life flashed before my eyes a few times. And yeah, they drive crazy. But that was my night one. It really wasn't much, because I started off very late. So I'm going to eat these food. I don't know if I'm going to eat these macarons, because I'm scared. Because they probably was here the entire time that, you know, not the entire time, but they probably was here at like maybe 3 when they cleaned. So I'm scared to eat them. You think I should YOLO or ditch them? Yeah, I don't know. I don't know. But so that was night one of Toronto. And I was pretty overdressed. They had like jeans or like bandeau tops. So I was pretty overdressed. And it's really not cold here at all. I think the low is 60 something, and it's not cold, which, you know, I was a little worried, because I wasn't sure if the coldness would be a factor where I need to get a jacket or something, but it's really not cold. I really didn't see too many people with a jacket on. But yeah. Oh, and I didn't tell y'all earlier, I got a jip by a taxi. He pretty much lied to me, but I was already in the car, so I said whatever. Like, I just needed to get to the hotel because I was hungry, and I've been traveling all day, and I was hot. So, yeah. I normally don't ever take... That's why people don't take taxis, because y'all try to jip people. Not all of y'all, but he jipped me, and I told him about himself, and he was like, well, you gotta understand. I'm like, you... Basically, he said because he was in the line at the train station, and now he has to move out the line, so... I have to put, you know, it has to be a flat fee. you knew good and well if you told me that 5 feet before I got in, I wouldn't have got in. So you played with me. And I told him, you being in a straight line and having to come out the straight line has nothing to do with me. But I paid it anyway because, like I said, but I ain't gonna let nobody else get me anymore. I'm strictly Ubers. But yeah, so that was my night one. I'm going to go ahead and eat, take this makeup off, get into my night clothes, and then I will see you tomorrow. All right. Oh, one more thing. So that Suya chicken wings and jollof rice, bomb. When I tell you, they know how to make jollof rice. It was so good. And then I never ate it like that. Well, I never had Suya before, but they had the onions on the side, and then I ate the onions with the chicken. Oh, it's so good. And it's not spicy to me. He was like, oh, it's really spicy. I'm like, you must not know about me, because I love spicy. It was just the amount of spice. Everything was really, really good. And it was chef's kiss. Whoever was catering for Lobby, they did their big one for that one. So I just wanted to come on and tell you guys that. So, all right, I'm getting ready to go to bed. Bye. Good morning. It is Saturday morning, and I'm debating whether I should get breakfast to my room or go to the restaurant to get breakfast. I'm kind of debating. I feel like I probably want to do breakfast in my room because I don't think I've ever had like room service. So maybe I should try that. I mean, I've always been in nice restaurants to get breakfast. So maybe I should try that. And maybe later on I can go and maybe get like a drink or something later on when I come back from my day. But yeah, let's do breakfast here. Breakfast, apple juice, I love juice, and everything. This is their hash browns. Looks a lot different. It looks like a potato croquette, but yeah, butter. So yeah, it's my breakfast for today. And I needed my jam. I think I should have got hot tea, but I'm very thirsty, so let's go ahead and get this devoured. I had already drunk a water out of the refrigerator, so I was so thirsty, and I didn't want to drink another water. Oh, they got salt and pepper. Do they got salt and pepper? Yes, they got salt and pepper. So I just was like, I'll just hold off till the morning time. And I have reservations for lunch soon anyway, so not really making it a big to do. So let's see how the eggs taste. Tastes like eggs. Chicken sausage is good. It tastes like a sweet instead of savory. Yeah, it's this hash brown is. Oh, you know what the hash brown is like? It's like Burger King hash browns, but in like a triangular notion. But definitely fried nice. Definitely fried nice. So I'm gonna finish eating and then I'll come back later. This is like the cutest, the Tabasco sauce is small. It is like the cutest thing. I love it. Yeah. Well, fun fact, my grandmother used to get like the McDonald's breakfast sandwiches. And she used to put jelly on her egg sausage cheese McMuffin. And when I was younger, I was like, why is she putting jelly on it? But now that I got older, yeah, it's clutch. It's clutch. It's like the sweet and savory, but when you're younger, you don't think of it like that. You just like, why are you putting jelly on your egg McMuffin with cheese and eggs? But it tastes so good. I just did that today. It reminds me of my Nana. It's good.
So this is my outfit for brunch.
All right, so currently I'm at the restaurant Sotto. So if any of you are hip hop heads, you know that Drake raps about this restaurant in his music. So I wanted to come and try it. So I ordered it's called the tomato caprese. It's that mozzarella ball and it's tomatoes surrounded by it. So they had regular size tomatoes cut up, and they also had cherry tomatoes and grape tomatoes. It was really, really good. I think I've had this before. No, I don't think I had this before, but it was really good. The restaurant isn't like what I assumed it was going to be. It's pretty open, and it's pretty much everybody is right around everyone. So it's not a thing where it's you have privacy. And this is the main dish. So I got it's a clam and white sauce spaghetti. It was pretty much, I was trying to pick between two entrees, and I really love octopus, so I should have kind of got the octopus, but I'm not a big fan of capers. But he did say he can leave the capers out. But I did ask him between the two what would he prefer, and he said he really did like this. I, however, did add Parmesan cheese to it. The guy came out and put it on there. And it wasn't like the shaved Parmesan cheese. It was the grated. But it was still really, really good. This dish, I'm gonna rate a 7 out of 10. I like my sauce to stick to my noodles. It was really good, so it was very flavorful. But I just like sauce to stick to my noodles, like a Alfredo cheese sauce. But pretty much, it was decent. Would I get it again? Probably not. But the decorum inside of the restaurant was really beautiful. But like I said, it is small, and I didn't expect it to be where everyone is pretty much on top of each other. So if I look to my left, somebody can look at me, and vice versa. It's not really too closed off. But it was really nice. It was a nice restaurant. The waiters were really nice. They were very knowledgeable. They didn't seem like it was too much to ask them a few questions about a dish or something on their menu. So I would definitely go here again if I end up going back to Toronto. Sotto is a really good place. I would recommend this place if you are able to travel to Toronto. So a lot of celebs come to Sotto while in Canada. So they had a lot of pictures of different celebs on the wall. So I tried to get a few. But if you go, just make sure that you look at all of the celebs that have been there. These are the bathrooms. This is nice and festive. So I want to apologize in advance. I was trying to be discreet while I was recording, so I didn't have my vlogging stand, and I wasn't really getting all the shoes like I was supposed to.
We have also this one. This is a really good color. It's just a bit lower.
Yeah, like this design.
You like that bit? Yeah.
It's a platform.
Yeah. I like that color, but that design.
I'm just going to sit down.
All right, so I am back. Why does my thing look like this? Hold on. Okay, so I'm back. I did a little bit of shopping and stuff. I don't know if I showed y'all my outfit. So this was the fit for today. This is vintage. The belt, I think it was a part of something, and I decided to use it for this, but I did show y'all my fit. I think I did show y'all my fit. And I got these from Nordstrom's black tights. And I pretty much felt okay the entire day. I was getting a little hot, and then we have some of the leopard print action here. And then these are also, you can see, these are also vintage. They're my grandma's. So yeah. Oh, well, let me show you what I got. I went to Ferragamo, as you seen that, and I did end up getting I did end up getting this. It smelled so good inside of the store. So, yeah. And it's a good size bottle. Things just falling, man. Falling, falling, falling. And then I went to Sephora and I picked up the Patrick Ta foundation. And I believe, let me see if it's full. Medium 4 was in fact a good color for me. But we'll see. I'm feeling like medium 3 probably was gonna be a better match, but I don't remember how I swatched it, so. I hope this works. If not, I'll just exchange it. But yeah. This is the Patrick Ta. And people were raving about it on TikTok. I really wanted to find like a foundation where I don't have to wear a whole boatload of foundation. I can just kind of throw something on. I don't have to do the whole, you know, contouring, all that jazz. And the reason why I wanted to do that is because I just been kind of into the minimal makeup look lately. I still like wearing a lot of makeup when I go out, but as far as like doing a day or if I'm doing something that's like not a big event to me, I don't like putting on a lot of makeup. So today I just have like my Chanel and my Too Faced, and then that's really it, and then a little bit of bronzer, and that's it. I have no clue why my mascara continues to do this. It does this every time. I literally have tried everything. Tonight when I go out, what I'm gonna do is when I put my mascara on, I'm gonna bake a little bit right underneath my eye, and I'm gonna leave it there for a few minutes to see if it runs on that, and so it doesn't leave this black mark. Because I've tried everything, y'all. So if you know any ways that I can have my mascara not do that, I literally have like 6 or 7 mascaras trying to make sure that it doesn't do that. And I've tried waterproof and it still does that. So, you know, if you have any suggestions, put it in the comment section. But yeah, so I'm going to go ahead and hop in the shower and I'm going to chill out for a little bit. And then I think I'm going to get ready at 6 because the concert is at 8, and I feel like if I start my makeup at 6 o'clock, it'll be done like an hour and a half. And so I just had to put on my outfit and bam, there you go. And I don't have to get there right at 8 o'clock, but I want to get there like around 8 o'clock. So on my lip I have Mario. Let me show you what it is. I love this lipstick. It's so cute. I have this Mario, it's in Cam. And then I also have Cork MAC liner. That's my OG MAC liner. Chestnut is a little bit too like dark for me. I love Cork. Oh, I've been wearing Cork since teens. So, well not teens, like late teens. So yeah, so I'm gonna go ahead and do that and yeah, and then just chill out because I've been up all day and walking. I'm gonna see how many steps came in today. So, and everybody really did say they love my hat. I got this from Amazon, y'all. Everything else is vintage, so I don't know when my grandma got it, so, you know. Yeah, I'm just gonna chill out. I will see you guys when I get ready for the concert.
Sorry, y'all, I'm like late, so I couldn't really get, you know, everything with everything, but this is the fit. I'll vlog when I get back or while I'm in there.
Bye.
I got a couple songs to perform, you know, I hope you don't mind.
I was trying to strike shit. Thank you.
shirt. Damn. This shit real snapping shoe. I got all the things that we came through. I got you. Hey, look what you done. Look what you done. Look what you done for me.
Very deeply, I care about my family. I care about my friends. I care about my beautiful boy. And I care about Toronto. All four of those things deeply. So, tonight, I hope that we can experience and relive.
Down for the car. Are you down?
Toronto, you better make some motherfucking noise tonight or buckle up.
Of a town called Bel Air.
deluxe. But so many flats, she still feel that shit in the guts. I'm high, fat muscle wet in a bus. I'm high, don't even ask her what's up.
She said, I waited, I waited. And tonight, I'm letting you know, manifestation is real. I prayed about this shit. I thought about this shit.
I'm too low in your words, watch a nigga backtrack. All I know, if I die, I'm a motherfucking legend. It's too late for Toronto, I'm the youngest nigga rapping. Oh my, oh my God, oh my God, if I die.
Walking back to the hotel. I refuse to let those taxis jet me again. But honestly, I'm almost there. My makeup held up good. So I'm back in the hotel. It really wasn't a far walk at all. A lot of people were walking. So I wasn't like walking alone. I have to pack because I have to leave in a couple hours, but my feet are killing me, like to the point I can't walk, killing me. So, and I had on tennis, so, and I have a big blister like right on my big toe. It's excruciating, it's painful. It's really painful. I don't know how I'm gonna do this in a few hours because nothing is basically packed. I had planned on coming in, taking a bath in the soaking tub, and then packing and going to sleep. But that doesn't look like that is going to happen because I'm trying to get my feet at some type of level where I can walk well enough. And I noticed, though, when I put my feet on the floor in the bathroom, because it's a floor warmer in there, it alleviates some of the pain, but not all. That basically concluded my Toronto trip. I'm just going right on back home and leaving the city. I had a great time, Toronto. The six, but it is time for me to go on home and sleep for a few days, hopefully. Sleep for a few days. So, yeah. Thank you guys for watching my vlog. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Turn on your bell notification so you are notified when I upload videos. Bye, stylistas.